You're good.
Happy Wednesday, everybody. It's Judy Hayes with Design Realty Group and
Darla Nunley with Design Realty Group.
Look, Darla's got a new shirt. We're Woo-hoo! Super excited that I don't have mine yet, but she has hers. We're going to get them. So we have new t-shirts. You are listening to us on Real Talk, two friends talking all things real estate. So today we're going to talk about staging and how very important it is. We're going to do a little bit different. We're going to move around with the camera a little bit, but Darla had perfect words earlier. Sellers, when you are getting ready to list your home, the first thing you need to think about is buyers are looking at this home through
HGTV eyes. We all sit around and watch HGTV and we absolutely love everything that we see. And all of a sudden, I know as a female, we start going out and we go into Target and Home Depot and we go on to
Home Goods and Kirkland's are dangerous places
Amazon,
to be. Hey, Allison.
And we start looking at how can we replicate what we're seeing because we like the new looks, right? Happens every single time.
It's the trend. So whatever's popular, you want the latest purse, ladies. You want the latest shoes. Think of it this way. I kind of was thinking on the way over here, Darla. When you go to the mall or you go to the furniture store to buy anything, what's the first thing you look at? The thing on the mannequin.
Right.
They're displaying their best items right there. So you catch that first. You don't dig three aisles back of that. You're looking at what's on the mannequin. They've already put it together. It's so cute. I don't even need to. That looks great. I don't have to go dig around and figure it out myself.
Right. And I know for me, sometimes I see the trends, whether it's for home or me personally, and I'll look at it and go, I don't like that. Mm-hmm. Right. And then it takes me a little bit after seeing it over and over and over again. Yep. But then guess what happens? I see it on someone that I think it looks really good on. And all of a sudden, I'm like,
maybe it looks good on me.
I kind of like it now. And so all of a sudden, our taste will start to evolve. And then we start trying to pull those different trends in, whether it's in your house or in your home. So that's kind of how we know things work.
Just remember, we're appealing to the masses.
Correct.
Okay, we're appealing to the masses. Might not be your style, might not be Darla and I's style, but we're appealing to the masses. And we're stagers ourselves. Courtney's a stager. We have Angela, Cam. We have multiple stagers that are accredited, but we also consult with outside stagers, especially with our luxury listings. I have a very good friend. I'm going to give her a shout right here. Julie Ann Interiors is Julie Baton. She is phenomenal. You know, she does luxury listings, and I'm the one at my own house. I'm like, oh my God, Julie's coming over like I'm moving stuff around because she's a stager and I'm like, she's gonna judge me because I mean everything she does is beautiful and top scale. Don't get your feelings hurt when it's your personal items. We're here to do a J-O-B.
Right.
And that is to get your home show ready. And kind of what we're going to do today is know the difference between living in your home that could be absolutely stunning.
Right.
Versus showing it to a new consumer. We see it in those different eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And anytime that we give you advice on what to do, we're not criticizing. We are actually trying to help you put that home in its absolute best light. So when people come through, we know what buyers are looking for, and we want to make sure they see what they want to see. And so you have to understand
that we're not
coming at you saying that you're not with current trends or whatever. We're trying to look at this as a business transaction for you and get you the most money and it's sold quickly because that typically it tends to be our seller's goals.
We're talking about staging, but everybody knows the first place you look for a house is online. Hey, Charles, thanks for watching. So if they look at your house online, obviously they're looking at pictures, right? Mm-hmm. So we're not talking about photography today. It'll be a different show. But before the photography is the staging.
Right.
If they can't get past the photos, if they don't like the staging, the photos and the staging, they're not coming to your house.
Right.
Okay. So then we have to get them to your house. And that is first step is from what they see online.
Right. Right. And we're no longer in a market. We keep saying this. We're going to keep honing it in. We're no longer in a market where we can just throw up a couple of photos.
We didn't do that anyway, let me
say. We never do that. But we're not in a position where we can just throw things up and they sell quickly. Homes are sitting on the market longer, and there are more homes for the buyers to look at. They have a lot more choices. So now we're back to normal before we were with the pandemic, where we're having to look at sellers and saying, okay, we need to do a little bit more to make sure that your house looks better than the one two streets over.
Exactly. In addition to that, if you're we're in the Kingwood and East Montgomery County area, every corner you turn is what? New construction. So if a buyer is looking at buying a home,
and you guarantee can they're looking at new construction.
They're looking at new construction. Okay. So we all know what new construction looks like. It's brand new. It's sparkly. It's shiny. It's warranty. They're throwing incentives like crazy. So now we have severe hot competition that we have to compete against with any resale house. So if they walk into a model home at any community, it's perfect. And it's because no one lives there.
Nobody lives there.
And the professional sale, you know, that's their job. But we need to look just like them or better because they're our competition now.
And we know when we've walked your home, we know the benefits of buying your home. So what we're trying to do is to get it to where it is comparable to what other people are seeing on HGTV or in the new homes, but then we're gonna add the benefit of what your home offers. Larger square footage for a smaller price, larger backyard. You're already set up with Wi-Fi. You're set up with in-house speakers. Mm-hmm. You're set up with things that you've gone and done to make your house comfortable. They're going to have to pour that money into the new construction because I guarantee you most of them are not getting sprinklers in there.
Blinds
are not on windows.
Plantation shutters, different things.
We're trying to make sure that we're pulling out the benefits of your home while they're looking at all this bright, shiny, light colors and brand new stuff.
And trends change about every 5 years. And we're coming up on that fifth year, you know. So if you're going to list your house, you want to meet with us. If you know something needs to be done, we're already, you know, we're not going to beat a dead horse. But if you know it needs to be painted, the answer is paint it. That's the answer. Mm-hmm. Because it's going to cost you money one way or another.
Right.
Is it a pain? Absolutely. But your buyer doesn't want to paint it just like you don't want to paint it. That's an example. And we will do what's called a walk and talk. And we kind of, I slung this on Darla as she walked in the door. I'm like, hey, let's walk my house. We're going to walk it. She's the agent. I'm the realtor. And I live here. Ricky and I live here every day, but living in it, and it's, you know, quote, well-kept. We don't have small children and pets. Well, we do have pets, but they're put up. That makes it very difficult to keep your house show ready at all times, but getting some tubs and buckets and things. So we're going to walk around a little bit, take a look, and just kind of show you what we would do with you. It's called a walk and talk to give you suggestions of what it can show better. And if you're like, why do I need to move that puppy thing? Because I don't want them to know you have a dog. You know,
right.
I don't want them to know because they walked in, they didn't smell puppy. We don't want to smell it, but they saw my puppy bin over there. Like there's a dog. Now they're looking for it. Now they're looking for chew marks. You know, they're looking for stuff.
Right.
So, again, the pricing, presentation, and promotion are your three P's of listing a home. So today we're talking about presentation and all of this takes place before you go on the market.
Correct. So, and this is where you come in.
And we work together.
We work together with this, the pricing portion of it. Your agent's going to handle, and then the promotion part of it, your agent's definitely going to handle. Mm-hmm. So the presentation part is where we're going to work together as a team, and if you will listen to what your agent is telling you to do and you do those things, you should see benefits from it, for sure.
Believe it or not, you may think it's a little regular, like, oh my God, they're being so nitpicky. That's our job. We're supposed to be that.
Right, and you wouldn't believe how many times after a client has done what I've asked them to do that they look around the home and they're like, and then they see the pictures online and they're like, I don't know that I want to move now, right? They're
that
kidding.
That just happened to me. I don't know if they're kidding all
the time. They're kidding, but I have a home that's going up on Friday, and it's a friend of mine, and we walk through that house, and I could tell it was like, you really want me to move that? And I'm like, yeah, it's small, but we need to move it. I call it, we'll talk about it here in a minute, but I call it visual chaos. Robert hears me all the time with my thing, but it's visual chaos. And when we have visual chaos in a house, the buyer's focused on the wrong thing.
Right.
So we want them focused on the right thing.
And we only have one time to make a first impression. We keep saying that. That's your curb appeal. We'll talk about it in a minute. But we're going to kind of do a walk and talk here. So we're going to, I want to go over here.
Let's start in the kitchen.
Let's start in the kitchen. So if you were coming in the front door, remember, the first thing you see and you smell. So you're walking in the front door, and this is kind of our view. So I like my kitchen, right? But if you're looking at this, I mean, I know what she's going to tell me to do. The first thing I want to show you really quick is, I'm going to backtrack, is look at the difference without the under counter lights and lighting on in this house.
So turn it back off?
Turn it back. Okay. Now watch. So when you leave your home for a showing, turn all the lights on. Okay. Turn all the lights on. I do have a candle, one candle. We don't want it to be an overwhelming smell that you're sneezing or coughing, but a little bit of scent is okay. Darla, go ahead.
Or actually, no scent as well.
Okay.
No scent is okay.
Yep. So just kind of pan around and kind of tell them what you would tell me to do if you were going to list the house.
Okay. So we all know that we're in the fall season right now. And the fall season, we have a lot of fall mums, fall flowers. We have pumpkins out. We have candy out. We have all those things that are decorating our home. I don't have an issue with those as long as it's not overwhelming. So as we walk through the kitchen, a couple of things that I point out.
She doesn't want me to have all this candy. Is
we're going to remove as much off the counters as we possibly can. Why do we do that? We do that because we want to create space. Buyers, when they walk in the door, they want to know that they have enough counter space to prep, to entertain, to clean, all those kinds of things, right? So the next thing, we're going to move this off.
And we move this.
We're going to move everything off the top of the counter there.
And this is my legs, I can't move it all the way. But we move this and we move this. And now, look how much cleaner the top of the counter is.
It's not, you don't have to remove everything. But we need that counter to be nice and clean now, right?
Don't want it naked.
Right.
We want it to show the space, darling.
Right.
Like that perfect.
Right. So then something like a drying towel here, okay? We want this off. What I tell my clients is find a bucket to put the things that you're using on a daily basis in the bucket. So when you have a showing, put those things in the bucket. And then pull them out when you need them, because we want the house looking like a model home, basically.
Right.
Okay, so we would take this, and we would pull this off. We would absolutely pull all of the items for the soap dispensers, paper towel holders go. So as we get over here to the counter, these are things that Judy uses on a daily basis. Guess what's coming off? All of these items.
That's for my toaster strudel.
Right. We can leave the happy fall, y'all. I don't even mind this up here, but we've got to get rid of the bags. We can leave this because this is an appliance item.
So one of the things, though, I know that my sellers ask a lot, I'm going to drink coffee every morning. I give them a little piece on that. You can leave your coffee maker out. Just be organized with your little carrots.
Keep
or whatever.
Keep it cleaned up, right.
Just minimize it. If you use it every single day, coffee's a big deal.
Right.
Everybody likes a little coffee area.
Right.
I don't have that because Ricky and I don't drink coffee, but a lot of people have that little section by their refrigerator, and they make,
right.
I know Brittany does, my daughter. It's a coffee bar, and so does Courtney. That's their little mom
That's
area.
That's cute.
Yes.
That's cute.
Decorate it like that.
Right. We're going to pull these items off, and we're definitely going to put food items away.
Okay, so
right?
Look, just see the difference here? Maybe we leave one.
Mm-hmm. You can leave the tea. Yep.
And we're done.
Yep.
Do you see the difference?
And now we have a huge counter
space
here, right? Towels, we're going to minimize what we see here.
We can't use our bare naked?
Nope. We can just pull it off and leave it really cute, right? Yep.
And if you're going to put a towel, Darla, wouldn't you say just do a solid color?
I would do a solid color, unless it's like Christmas or something like that. You can have a seasonal type of decor up there.
Not
now, Judy's
fingers.
Got dog, she's
this
got her
bad.
Dog things here.
I knew she was going to say that.
We have to put these things away, especially for a showing. So when we do photos, we're going to put these things away. And then when we have a showing, we're going to hide them in a pantry. Judy has a pantry.
Okay, we're going to critique the pantry.
That we can hide in here. So when you open up the pantry, my sellers always ask me, do I have to take everything out of the closets, out of the pantry? No. What I tell you is make sure that this is nice and organized. We don't want to open it up and find bugs on the bottom of the floor. We don't want to find clutter. If you can, organize it somewhat.
With baskets.
We don't want to show the very top.
Don't.
We're going to organize all of these items to kind of...
Yeah, that's the adult section. And also on the floor, what I tell my people is get everything off the floor. If you move all of that out, that's all my order. You need to take that out, go put it in your garage or something, because it literally makes it super. I just hit something.
Yeah, it's gonna make it look a lot bigger in here. But when you organize it, it's gonna make it look really good. And women who love the kitchen is what kitchens and bathrooms is what sells it for women. Having a nice size pantry and lots of counter space to do things is key for them. Okay.
And one of those things, I see these huge houses. I mean, Courtney and Brittany both live in on it. Brittany's pantry is pretty big, but Courtney has this little pantry. When you've got five bedrooms and four kids, you need a big pantry. There's a lot of kids.
You do need a big pantry.
Snacks and stuff going on there.
Right. So Judy has fall decorated her table. I like the way that this is decorated. Our designers will tell you yellow is a great color. Yellow brings happy. It brings bright, and it actually pulls people's focus towards something. I always have my clients put some kind of yellow in their kitchen, because where I want to focus the most, we'll have the yellows. Now, the one thing that Judy's going to kill me on here, I'm going to let you look at her really beautiful... See up here in the top, right up there? Those items up there, we're going to minimize all of those.
Michelle told me to put all those up.
We're going to pull some of those down because we don't want it visual going up. Because guess what you've probably not done up there?
Dusted.
You haven't dusted it. So we're going to make sure we pull some of that down to where they see that they can decorate, but we don't want it so decorated up there that it's now, that's where their visual goes, right? Okay.
Where are we going next?
So let's talk about entryway.
Yes. So I don't have much of an entryway. You come in, so the actually coming in through the double doors is, you know, they're very nice doors. When you come in, we have a good fixture, but I don't have an entryway per se. I'm walking right into my house. So it's very important. The stairs, obviously the puppy gate needs to go right there. And then you're really going to see a formal dining area right here. The good news here is, you know, we try to have date night here once a month, but it's really used for holidays and kids' birthdays in here.
And you'll see a lot of people do this. We all do it. We have family photos and pictures here. One of the main things that our stagers will tell you to do, remove all family photos from the home. Why? Because we want the buyer to be able to visualize them in the space, not you. We're trying to move you into a new home. We're trying to move them in here. So removing your personal items with pictures, and I'm going to even say minimize all of those word art things that we all love to put out. We're going to minimize that. And I will say, I haven't seen it in a little while, but cross walls used to be huge. You have to pull those items down. Why? Because you have to appeal to them, as many buyers as you possibly can. And it's visual chaos. You do not want them focusing on the items that you decorate with. We want them to be able to visualize, oh, I can put our family photos across the dining room wall here. Look how big that is. Okay. So you want to go to the master?
Okay, we'll go to the master. So one of the things that I like to say with your bedrooms is have a solid colored comfort. I'm walking backwards with my head. This is probably not attractive at all. I like some color. I repainted this so it's not all brown in here. It was all brown, but I just want to turn the lights on and let you see the difference with the lights on. Lamps are huge in your bedroom, especially by your bedside table. She's already going to tell me to minimize. I got glasses that I can't read. I've got books on the side. We've got pictures. So on these end tables, we want the lights on. You turn this plant so you don't see that price tag on there, and you minimize that way. So you've got a solid color with a little bit of pop. I do have a sitting area here. Of course, if you turn that way, you will see that that's the man area where all his things are stacked, because he's got to keep his hat and his keys and all that stuff that would need to come off there.
And again, baskets work wonders.
Yes,
you can take a basket and put it on the floor and just drop all that stuff in there. People know that you live in the home.
Right.
It's all about the clutter and what you do with the vision. When people walk through here, what they see.
If you didn't see it, we would remove the puppy chairs, the puppy stairs, they would need to go.
The puppy stairs would need to go. I would have her remove the photos off of here. And even over here on this table, I would have her remove the photos off of here and just minimize what you see here.
Basically a lamp and one more lamp.
Right, and I don't have an issue with anything in the corner at all.
In your bathroom, of course, you use this all day every day. It's one of the hardest places to keep show ready because we're running like crazy in the morning trying to get dressed. And it's just difficult to get all that stuff away. Again, for the third or fourth time, baskets, girls, your hair stuff. This needs to go under here, be organized, because I will say this. People, when they are interested in your home, they're going to open these cabinets. They're going to open these doors because they're trying to see how much space that you do have in there. And so they're going to be digging around. Oh, you know what? That's a lot of space. You don't have a linen closet. I don't have a linen closet in my bathroom because when I designed this house, it was over there and I wanted a separate vanity. So we built this and you're like, you know what? That actually is a lot of storage with these drawers, which is what, you know, I have stuff in it, but they can still see.
But again, open this up. What Judy's done here is she has organized it with baskets. So it's not thrown in there, piled 5 inches high. It is actually organized in baskets. So when they open it up, there's no fear of things falling out on them.
Yes.
Number one. Number two, they can see that everything in here is nice and clean and organized, and it helps to kind of give them a sense of peace that things are actually taken care of, mm-hmm. and that they care about their home. You would absolutely have to remove all of these items.
All your cleaning stuff.
You would have to get a basket, put these items in there, pull it in there when you want to take a shower, when you get a showing. All you have to do is take the basket and put it in some other spot.
I can't tell you how bad that looks in pictures.
Oh, it's
bad. To have
bad.
Your bath wash and your loofah right. thing everywhere. Right. Don't do that.
Right.
Another thing, ladies, you know this. Your closet is huge. I love my closet. I love it. Had it custom built in here. And it shows very well, but I got a lot of stuff in here. So when you come through, the main thing when you're looking at closets is nothing on the floor in your closets. Nothing on the floor. We have some nice built-ins showcasing here. Again, nice drawer. Ooh, don't look in there.
Well, and I will tell you... I'm a little concerned.
I just
the whole purpose of this was for you to be organized, and she's got them swapped off in
there.
Well,
I sold some this weekend. It was a hot mess. But a lot of things, I did have an agent. I won't say his name, but he's a friend. What he does, and I was like, he makes his clients take like 2/3 of their clothes out of the closet. I was
and
like,
spread them
what?
Out. Spread them out.
And spread them out because there's a lot of space in here. But man, I have way too many clothes just like everybody else does. But you've got good shelving in here for shoes, good storage. You just need to minimize this. Same thing here. I like this little cool thing we've got safe in there. There's mm-hmm. your laundry hidden mm-hmm. in there and just a bunch of stuff mm-hmm. in there. Now we're going to go to the laundry room, which one of my favorite features, a lot of new houses do it, come from your closet into your laundry room. Mine's a total disaster. I wasn't planning for this. This is an example of what not to do right here. Okay. I do have a small laundry room, but it's holding laundry right now.
Right.
So everything off the shelves, everything off the counters, no hanging clothes, no clothes hangers. Organize that a little bit better. You've got stuff up there, but just make it prettier and cleaner mm-hmm. and smoother in there. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yep.
We'll go in here. We don't have to go into the half bath, but make sure your half bath... hey, Gladys. Thanks for watching. Make sure half bath has toilet paper and hand sanitizer and soap in there because nobody likes to go potty in someone else's bath, but sometimes they have to, you know. So make sure you've got hand towels and toilet paper in there. When you come back around, another example of what not to do. I have an office... and it is clearly a working office. Too many pictures, too many everything. But you gotta
I would say this is a big example of visual chaos.
Yes, this is chaos.
And so this is a really good example. So when you're if you were to walk into a home that had all of this going on, I can tell you my buyer's first thought would be, wow.
She is a hot mess.
There's a lot going on in here, right? Whereas if you come through here and you minimize, you'd have to pull all the photos off. I don't mind the decor, but you have to pull all the photos off. Over here, we would definitely move what's on either side and we would leave this in the middle. I would have you pull off as much of this as possible, understanding that you still have to work. I get that, but you have to be more organized when you're showing your home.
And the other reason, let me tell you why we're doing this. It's difficult to do it, but what it's also going to do is keep you on the market for a very small amount of days. So if you do what we say from day one, the days on the market will be shorter, and then you will be inconvenienced a shorter amount of time.
Right.
And once you're under contract, you can breathe
a little bit.
The showings are going to stop. They're going to have inspections, and no one cares if your dog toy is on the floor during inspections. You've got the buyer. Inspector doesn't care what it looks like, okay? Your appraiser doesn't care. So if you get it, have that inconvenience for a few days and get it all packed up and organized. Plus, remember, we're moving to a new house. Get yourself packed up and ready to go because now you're going to be excited for where you're going.
Right. Correct. Right. And I always tell my clients too, look, you're moving anyway, right?
Yeah.
It is a great time when you declutter to start packing things away. You're not going to need most of this stuff anyway now that you're living. Mm-hmm. So let's go ahead and start packing it up. It means less packing for you later. And it helps us with staging the home, and you can get rid of a lot of the clutter, right?
We're going to take a peek outside. We're going to look at the pool area really quick, but we're actually going to give you a behind the scenes what it looks like on our staging. We actually have a DRG staging trailer. We have a warehouse here, and we have storage sheds for decor. We can stage about 12 homes at a time, fully staged. Bedrooms, we don't have as many bedroom furniture as that, probably 4 or 5, I'll have to ask Courtney. But we're just gonna give you a peek behind the scenes. We try to go from house to house, that makes it easier. Doesn't always happen, so we pull what we need, and I can't tell you how many times we're on the way and picking up a rug at home goods on the way.
So far we've talked about staging and we've talked about a deep clean. You want to go through and deep clean everything through the home. The reason that you do this, you want the bunnies, the hair,
the dust bunnies
out of the way. Yeah. You want the dog hairs off the floor. You want the caked on dirt that's on all the
ceiling fans. Fan, when you turn the ceiling fan off, oh my goodness,
you want all the corners cleaned up. There's bugs in the pantry. You know, things that most of us keep a very clean house, but you wouldn't believe, you know, when you walk through there, you're like, I cannot believe I didn't touch the top of that cabinet for the last 6 months, right? And then we can help you with, we have people that can help get hard water scale off, mold and mildew out of a shower. You know, and if you need to do those things yourself, I can certainly point you towards some YouTubers because my daughter is a very clean freak. And we've been turned on to some really good things. We've talked about decluttering. Let's talk a little bit about curb appeal, because the curb appeal is one of the very first things, the first impression that a buyer's going to have online. The first thing that we usually post is that outside picture, right? And we want to make sure that the outside of the home is the very
first wow factor.
So they know when they walk into that home, the outside's going to reflect to what's on the inside. So if you're doing all this wonderful stuff on the inside and you've not taken care of the yard on the outside, that's not going to help with your curb appeal. So a lot of people, they tell us we don't have a whole lot of money, we can't do a whole lot of things. It doesn't take much to spruce up the outside of the home.
Yeah, we're going to power wash for sure, and this is a great time to do an outdoor video. I don't know that I've ever had flowers before, but look, there's flowers, you know. I'm not really a green thumb. I'll say that a lot. You'll see a lot of rocks in my yard because I can't kill rocks, but you can try really hard.
Right, so we talk about color. We want color. We talk about mulch. Judy doesn't have a whole lot of mulch because of where she is. She doesn't need the mulch. But we've got some kind of visual to help guide people into the front door. As they're walking into the front door, you want to make sure that they have a nice, clean path. Power washing the driveway, power washing the front porch area, getting all the dirt and the cobwebs off the top of the doorway, making sure that if your door hasn't been painted or if it's a wood stained door, you want that to be restained and repolyurethaned, because that is going to tell people, if you can't take care of the front door, what are you doing to the inside
of
the home?
And that front door is one of the, when I walk up, as I'm taking notes on a listing appointment, you'll see me taking notes. The front door is the first thing I see because it looks stale. It looks old. It's dried. And it's way your house is facing towards the sun. If you're that east-west, man, that door takes a beating.
Death.
It gets beat to death. So I have a covered porch. So my doors are actually almost 8 years old, and I've never refinished them. And there's one reason for that. Well, I am not east-west, but my porch is covered. My doors are protected with that. So just know that. If you're in a new home community and you've just got that flat front, after about every 2 years, you need to varnish that door.
Whether
and I can
it's
tell
wood
you,
or plastic.
Yeah, I can
matter.
Tell you it's about $800 to have that done on a door.
And at DRG, one of the things that we always do when we stage, we've always got color on the front door. Yeah. So there's some kind of wreath or something, a welcome sign, flowers, something that's going to be welcoming into that home.
Yeah. One of those tall wood things that say welcome. Courtney likes to use that or something. Right. I didn't know if you showed
And
them
I will tell you that I would tell Judy, you got to remove the owl.
I have a lot of yard art because I can't keep the plants
has metal, lots of metal.
We're going to take a quick shortcut through here. Don't look at the
garage. One of the other things, if you have a lot of these neighborhoods have these oak trees that they've planted in the front yard. A lot of them, the HOAs require two oak trees or two trees in the front yard. Those trees, after 5 or 6 years, have grown so big. We can't even see the front of the front of the house. So I'm going to tell you, let's get an arborist over and let's kind of trim those trees up and pull the bushes down. We want the front windows to be seen, and we want the front of the house to be as open and airy as you possibly can. Plus, it's good for the trees because you get lots of circulation in the trees, and the disease isn't able to set in over there. So here we are. We're walking to the back.
So we have our own staging trailer that is DRG specific. It holds a lot in there. So we sometimes have to hire outside people. I have a wonderful son-in-law, grandson's getting promoted to the staging. Courtney does a lot of that. A lot of times they go house to house, which is easier. But when we have extra stuff, we have, again, I said about 13 houses worth of stuff. We had to build out an entire cover here. This is our big warehouse area that holds our large furniture. We've got it really organized in here so that when the boys come in, they can actually see. And in the back is a lot of decor. We actually had a huge garage sale this past weekend because we got rid of all that
older stuff.
And we had picked it up. We've done this about 3 years now. And I will say, we're losing power. We're going to go back that way. That we have ever done. But we unloaded so much stuff that was orange and red and wasn't gray and white. Pretty much, watch your step. We weren't doing it anymore.
Right.
Okay. All right, Yvonne, we're going back. She was losing us. So this is the backyard again. If you have a swimming pool and a backyard area, this is your money shot. This is probably going to be the first picture that we have on any website for you. And this is what people are going to buy this house for. The house they might like, but you're going to be sold on this area back here. This is what your family, your friends, your kids are really going to enjoy. So you want to make this shine and sparkle and be at its absolute very best.
Right. So Judy, what do you tell your clients with a pool? What do you tell them to do when they have a showing come through?
Turn the waterfalls on. I have it off just because it's so noisy right now. Turn the waterfalls on. Have it going. My pool actually needs that little power wash to get the line off. I don't have a saltwater pool, but it's time to do that. My particular patio needs to be refinished out here on my pool decking, but everything else is pretty new. We did this last year.
Right.
And it's definitely our family and friends.
But we're going to turn the TV on, either have music or some kind of sports or something playing, because obviously that's what most people
do
with this. So we want to create an environment and an experience so when they walk out the door, they can actually see themselves sitting out here on a Saturday watching sports, barbecuing with the family, or enjoying just a night out, you know, outside with friends. And
this is Ricky and I's date night. If any of y'all are sitting around wondering, what is Judy doing on Friday night? This is what we're doing. This is our place.
Right.
This is our happy place. This is our personal resort. And
Right. That's
where we want to be. So if you have a home with these features, know that you want to sell it.
Or let's say that you don't have this expanse that Judy has here. Let's say you just have a back patio, doesn't have a cover on it, and you've got a huge backyard. If you can do something to make that inviting,
a little rug down.
Judy has patio furniture that you can use to kind of stage the patio. A fire pit. If you go buy a fire pit and kind of set that up with a couple of chairs around it, you would not believe what a backyard space of any kind doing anything.
And even that portable cover from Home Depot that you can get for a couple $100 to say, if you don't have any cover, it's awful hot in the summer.
Or even just an umbrella with a base on it, right?
With a table and chairs. Right. That would look good.
Right. So you're just looking to create a space, an inviting space that your neighbor may not have. Maybe your neighbor can't afford or doesn't care about his outdoor space. But it's going to be huge when you're having buyers walk through here. And they're trying to determine whether they like the 225 house here or the 225 house down the corner or yours at 235. That's going to make a huge difference if you've got a space that's a little bit different from the other people in the neighborhood.
Well, you made a good point. So especially on new construction, you've got these back, they don't have trees, they don't have anything in there. And you're going up a new construction, you walk out to your house that has a patio. They're huge. I mean, I don't know why they even build houses. Hey, Brian, thanks for watching. I don't even know why they build houses without patios in Texas. Everybody loves it. It's hot. But it's a space for your kids. It's a place for your fur babies. It's if you had a blank backyard, which is what she's just saying, you're competing against the neighbor next door, and you put some more effort with some color out there. Everybody in Texas loves a fire pit. It's hot and sweating, but we're going to have us a fire pit, and we're going to roast some hot dogs and s'mores on there, and you have a rug and a table and some chairs out there. It just sets that precedence of what it can be when you and your family come there.
Right. Or even just a couple of chairs in an ice box or like a ice chest or a table or a place to even plug a TV in so you can pull a TV in and out.
Mm-hmm. So Game days are big.
Right. So Judy and I, we always have a lot of really good ideas for the properties that are a little bit harder to stage. We've always got really good ideas, and Courtney's really good at coming up with things to do as well. So the equipment is here. The ideas are here. You just have to let us in the door so you can see what we've got to offer.
We appreciate you taking your time to be with us today. If you couldn't see us live, please watch it again. Staging is huge. Making that presence as people are looking at you online, but then when they get there in person, what they see and what they smell within the first 5 seconds of walking in your door is going to make you or break you.
That's exactly right. So we talked about a couple of weeks ago on the sellers, we talked about the three P's: pricing, presentation, and promotion. Today was about presentation. To help you sell successfully, The DRG team has a whole lot to offer in terms of helping you get on the market. 78% of staged homes sell faster and at a higher price than those that do not. So keep that in mind. Now, I'm about to head out, and I'm going to head over to
Royal Brook.
It's Courtney's listing that is staged, and I'm going to do a quick video over there and show you what we do as a brokerage on staging. This is an empty home. No one lives in this home. They've already moved out, but Courtney went and staged this, and it looks absolutely beautiful, and I'll give you details on that once I get over there. So hang tight. Make sure you check in on the Facebook page and see that video a little bit later.
Let me say one more thing. Number one, with DRG, the staging is absolutely free and complimentary. So why would you not do that? So quick question, Darla. Why would you stay? Is it empty? Is it better to just leave it empty or to stage it? Why would we just not leave it empty?
We always want to stage it because buyers, when they walk through there, they need to be able to envision the space. A lot of people have a hard time with spatial conceptions. So if they have this huge sofa, they're not really sure from looking at the pictures, number one, if their huge sofa will fit in there, right? So number two, they need to be able to feel it that it's home. It's cozy.
It's
warm and welcoming. They always sell better if they've got some staging in them.
And also the rugs that we put down help the echoing and the noise type of thing. And you can just, it's like a model home. If you're going to a model home versus an empty home and it's the same neighborhood and they're both brand new, which one do you like better?
Right.
You like the staged one because you can visualize. And I can tell you, staging is hard, and being a decorator or an HGTV star, those people are not everyone. You know, if you walk into a room with horse blinders and it's set up as an office and you don't need an office, you're like, well, I don't really need this house. It doesn't work for me. No. Just because it's currently set up as an office doesn't mean you have to use it at all. What do you need it for? And we can help you with that because most people can't visualize like that.
So what are we doing next week?
What are we doing next week? Is this a test? Because I'm about to fail.
Don't remember.
We'll let you know.
We had so many things in line, I don't think we knew what next week was.
Well, we're still coming back and recuperating from the Astros win last night.
Right.
It was awesome. We're not even going to mention that we left at the top of the ninth inning and missed the home run. Oh, my God. Everybody's been screaming at us. It was horrible, but we won. So that they won because we left.
When did they win? Because we left.
Well,
we did go get ice cream, and Verlander actually started doing a lot better.
That's
so.
When we scored our first run, when we went ice cream, and everybody around us is like, leave, go get something to eat. They're doing better. So we left, and that's why they won.
That's right.
Thank you, guys. We will see you next week, and we'll let you know what we're going to talk about as soon as we remember.
Right. Real Talk Live, Wednesdays at 11. Make sure that you tune in. If not, over on our YouTube page, we've got this episode that will be up there, and then we've got all of the other episodes that have some really great information. So if you don't have anything to do,
watch it.
Watch us. Bye.
Bye.